Hey everybody, I'm back. Today I'm going to put my corset on for you guys, basically explain why I recommend getting a steel bone corset instead of a fashion corset or a cincher. Cinchers are not necessarily for waist training. They're more so like if you just want to get the hourglass figure, but it doesn't stay. So say if you stop wearing your corset for your cincher for any reason, and you gain weight. Well, your waist size is going to increase. However, with a corset, it won't. This is actually real waist training with a steel bone corset. That's what it is. A cincher is more so for strictly weight loss purposes. A steel bone corset is if you want to permanently reduce your waistline and permanently keep that hourglass figure. So, I mean, it's basically whichever you prefer. If you prefer to go with a cincher, then by all means, go ahead. You have to do what fits you best. I didn't want a cincher because I just don't. I don't want to have to, you know, go back to it if I gain more weight and then, okay, well, I want to pull everything back in again. I want to squeeze everything back in again. No, I didn't want to go through all of that. So, this is the course that I have. I have a CS411, and as you can see, it has the metal bust down the front of it right here, and then these here are the steel bones. I have 16, and it's double boned, so these little steel rods that you feel right here, this is double boning, and it basically helps hold the structure, hold your body in place. So that's why I like it. The cinchers, you know, they come with one row, two rows, or whatever. This, it only has the metal bust. So once this is clasped shut, that's it. But the back has the laces. And as you can see, the string is really, really long. So unlike the cinchers, once you reach that third row, say if you want to cinch in some more, that's it. But with the corset, you know, you still have room to do it. So that's why I chose this. So who knows how small I might want to get. I might want to cinch it all the way closed. But with a corset, even though, say if you are a 32 and you order maybe a 26 or a 24 waist, once your waist gets to a 24, if you want to cinch smaller than a 24, then yes, you will have to order another one. But that's that. So now I'm going to basically stand up, show you guys before and after. Don't judge me. Alright, so this is me before. This is me right now. No corset, no nothing. Here it is. Baby fat, whatever. Just had a kid, but this is right now. So what I'm going to do is unclasp it. And they also come with a little modesty panel. I don't use it. This is just, you know, if you don't want anybody to see what shirt, color shirt or whatever you have on, or if you don't want the laces touching your skin, this is what that's for. I don't use it, however. I'm used to wearing mine without it, so I don't use it. But here it is. And I haven't figured out yet if I'm going to put this over or under my shirt. I'm not sure yet. I think I'm just going to go with under today. I said, don't judge me, y'all. And these things are not the easiest to put on, FYI. But they're well worth it, and I love mine, so yeah. Now, with the CS411, the reason why it's so important to measure your torso is because you see how it cuts off? Like, I have on black pants, so you might not be able to see, but it cuts off right here. And now that's too low for you. You can always, you know, pull your corset up some, you know. I don't really pull mine up all the way because I measured my torso appropriately, so I don't need to. But here's that modesty panel. Like I said, I don't use it. So as you can see here, like all the straps and the laces and everything. And now right now, my lines in the back are parallel to one another. And that's what you want. You want your lines to be parallel even while you're tight lacing. And I often wear a bra that I can like cover it up if I'm wearing it under my shirt. So what you do is you're gonna start off with the top one, pull the top strap down, pull the bottom laces up, and you can just continue to do that, like alternate between the top laces and bottom laces until you get to a point where, okay, you're like, oh wow, you know, that's tight. Then you can stop and you can tie it off. With me, today I'm going to be doing a lot, like with trick-or-treating with the kids or whatever, so I'm not going to have it as tight as I normally would have it, only because I don't really like feeling that constricted when I'm trying to do things with the kids. So that's that. Like I said, you want to make sure that you are parallel, so you don't want to be like this. Don't want to be like this, where it's in the middle and then the straps are going out, and you definitely don't want to be like this. What you will do if you don't keep everything parallel, you will mess up your corset. It won't be able to contour and form to your body appropriately. And each time, if you lace differently each time, your corset will never form. It'll never fit your shape, ever. So, that's that. And I usually, like when I wear it under my clothes, I usually just, you know, fix it up, rearrange it before I tighten any further. And then I go ahead and I, you know, just pull my pants up over it. But this is it. All strapped and laced up. I don't even know if you guys caught that, but here it is. Laced up nicely. Everything is parallel. Now, if they're loose, just pull them. That's all you have to do, is just pull the string until it tightens up, you know, for your preference. You don't have to overdo it or anything. Actually, a lot of reports where people are, because I got inboxes where girls are like, oh, you're crazy, and like, you're going to hurt yourself, you're going to end up in the hospital. No, that happens when you don't follow instructions and when you're just doing too much. There's no reason to basically over tighten. There's no reason. I mean, if you're not used to tightening up a corset, don't take it full throttle the first week you have it. Like, that's just common sense. Your body is not used to this. You aren't used to it. Yes, you do have to adjust your breathing. You do have to drink plenty of water. So, I mean, this isn't a cincher. This isn't a walk in the park. Like, this is serious. So, please follow all instructions. I mean, I would even go far as consulting with my doctor to make sure that it's okay. Like, if you have asthma or any kind of breathing problems, respiratory issues, I would definitely consult someone in that profession. I would definitely consult my doctor to see if it's okay or if it's something that he or she recommends you do. So this is after. This is, I'm all cinched in. Everything is laced up. And all I do with my straps is I just take them and I wrap them around, tie them in the back, and then I tuck them into the back of my corset like this. So, you know, I don't just have strings dangling around or whatever. That's how I do that. But this is after. And so now with my shirt on, this is after. See, like, I have a waistline. Like, my waistline is more defined. Here it is right here. And then, as you can see, hips are out. Those ain't going nowhere. Sorry, ladies. If you have hips, just because you waist train, they're not going nowhere. But there you go. So, that was that. I do want to order, though, the CS426. Not because I'm really interested in wearing it, but because I've gotten a lot of questions about it, and I can't really answer those questions because, personally, I don't know. I haven't had it. So I don't want to give any advice to anybody about a corset that I haven't even tried myself. So when I do order that one, I will let you guys know. For everybody who was following my channel before, the reason why I was gone, I haven't updated, I haven't let anybody know other than via Facebook, is because I was pregnant, had a baby, and of course, pregnancy, waist training, can't do it. Common sense. So that's why I wasn't here. That's why I didn't update anybody on anything. Other than that, inbox me questions, drop a comment in the description box. I'm going to put the link to Orchard Corset, also my Facebook page. I have two. I have Amarish Warren. You can inbox me on. I have Amarish Waist Trainer Warren, which I'm also going to upload this video to that one in case you are my friend on that page. Until later. Bye, guys.